On the 25th of December, 2021, the James Webb Telescope left the Earth as the most expensive and powerful space exploration gadget ever made. And less than a year later, the super-intelligent spyglass has already made its mark with endless mind-boggling and brain-twisting discoveries that we never even imagined we'd be seeing in the 21st century. So it's time to unravel what the James Webb Telescope has to offer. After several months of traveling through the emptiness of space and additional months of calibration of the onboard equipment, the James Webb Telescope was ready for its first assignment, which was to capture the Southern Nebula ring 2,000 light-years away. Webb shot this amazing picture using both its near-infrared and mid-infrared cameras. The more clear image on the left was captured by the near-infrared camera, which is the telescope's best capturing device, while the one on the right was shot by the mid-infrared camera. The scene itself was created by a dying white star that spilled over a huge fraction of its mass in successive waves. At first glance, the brownish and reddish clouds of gas and two tiny dots are visible. Actually, these are not dots, they're stars. One is super bright, while the other is a dim, dying star. It's dim because it's been sending out things like gas and dust in different directions for thousands of years. The brighter star will likely do the same thousands of years from now, but until then, it will continue to influence the nebula's appearance. This right here is another breathtaking sight captured by the near-infrared camera. It is the edge of a giant and gaseous cavity within the Carina Nebula that's located approximately 8,500 light-years away from our Earth. Yet it looks very much like a 3D animation of the great craggy mountain on a moonlit evening. Webb's image of the Carina Nebula showcases different fascinating elements, including stellar nurseries, cosmic cliffs, and hundreds of never-seen-before individual stars and galaxies. Webb's ability to penetrate the thick dust and clouds to present the nebula even down to the smallest details is exciting. Scientists believe that the ability to decode this image could tell us more about how the stars are formed in the universe. But more importantly, it showcases our natural celestial elements in forms that were previously impossible to see. Every dot of light we see here is an individual star, and many of these likely also have planets, NASA's astrophysicist Strawn Amber said. SMACS-0723 is a galaxy cluster captured with the high-resolution imaging gadgets aboard the James Webb Telescope through a technique known as gravitational lensing. This is quite iconic because it is one of the first deep-field images that we've seen since we began exploring space a little over 50 years ago. Thanks to the near-infrared camera, we are able to see this cluster of galaxies exactly the way it was 4.6 billion years ago. At the center of the image, you've got the bright white elliptical galaxy as well as the small white galaxies that appear sparsely throughout the image. Both are bound by gravity in a galaxy cluster. The masses of the galaxy and dark matter combined act as a cosmic telescope to create magnified, contorted, and sometimes mirrored images of separate galaxies. In the same way as the other pictures shot by the James Webb Telescope, the image of the SMAC galaxy cluster will give scientists more insights into the formation and evolution process of galaxies. Closing out the list of Webb's first images released by NASA on July 12, 2022, we have the enormous mosaic of the Stephens Quintet. This is a super large image of five galaxies. According to scientists, the mosaic is equivalent to 1/5 of the moon's diameter. For perspective, to make the final image, scientists paired 1,000 separate image files, which combined to produce over 150 million pixels. Just like the image of the Southern Ring Nebula, Stephens Quintet was captured by Webb's near-infrared camera, also known as NearCam, and mid-infrared instrument, aka MIRI. And expectedly, the result is much more pleasing to the eye than we could have ever imagined. Jupiter is certainly not a new discovery to scientists. It's well known as the biggest planet in our solar system, and astronomers have been imaging it as far back as the 1800s. But on August 22, 2022, the James Webb Telescope showed us another perspective of this giant world of extremes with its enormous storms, super-fast winds, and intensely cold temperatures. This new perspective was presented to us through three specialized infrared filters. The different wavelengths in the image are represented by different colors. For instance, the shortest wavelengths appear in red, while the longest ones are presented in blue. The stunning image of Jupiter captured through the sophisticated lenses of the James Webb Telescope features the Great Red Spot, which is the planet's most significant characteristic. Furthermore, it showcases the mammoth storm that's larger than our Earth, as well as the auroras that stretch to high altitudes above the northern and southern poles. Shortly after capturing Jupiter in three filters, the James Webb Telescope moved farther into deep space to capture the sparkling faint rings around Neptune. These rings were first captured by the Voyager spacecraft during its 1989 flyby mission around the planet to capture the sparkling faint rings around Neptune. The Hubble Space Telescope offered us an even better view, showing the visible light in elegant shades of blue. However, the James Webb Telescope takes things to a whole new level, capturing the view of the ice giant and the surrounding rings in a way that we've never seen before. Webb captured Neptune at wavelengths ranging from 0.6 to 5 microns. In the image shot by Webb, the planet doesn't appear blue because its methane-rich composition absorbs infrared wavelengths, which makes the planetary body appear dark overall. However, high-altitude methane ice clouds appear lighter and brighter because they reflect sunlight. Further deep into space, the James Webb Telescope peered 159,800 light-years from Earth to capture the Tarantula Nebula, one of the most stunning nebulas in the universe. Again, this was possible thanks to the near-infrared camera and mid-infrared instrument. The color contrast between these two gadgets reveal bright, hot clusters of enormous young stars in blue through the near-infrared camera and cooler, dim gas through the mid-infrared camera. It gives us a privileged view of hidden stars in the dust of this stellar nursery. Seen here is the inner Orion Nebula, as shot by the near-infrared of the James Webb Telescope. According to scientific data, Orion is the closest large star-forming region to Earth. This crystal-clear image depicts the interior of the celestial phenomenon as a glossy oil painting. In addition, this composite image of the Orion Nebula, located 1,500 light-years away from Earth, is presented in multiple filters that depict ionized gases, hydrocarbons, molecular gas, dust, and scattered starlight emissions. Lastly, the nebula supports the numerous massive and young stars of the Trapezium cluster and spreads across 24 light-years. Formed around 15 to 20 million years ago, HIP 65426b is a relatively young exoplanet. But ironically, it's about 6 to 12 times heavier than Jupiter. This exoplanet was actually first discovered by the SPHERE instrument on the ESA's Very Large Telescope in Chile. But the exquisite imaging lenses and monographs on the James Webb Telescope allow us to see the young gas giant at different wavelengths in infrared light. This scary image of the IC 5332 by Webb's mid-infrared is best described as the bones of a galaxy. This phenomenal cosmic place is situated over 29 million light-years away and measures about 66,000 light-years across. This makes it slightly larger than our Milky Way. The image was captured in the 5 to 28 nanometer wavelength range and shows gray cobwebs in the shape of a spiral. Experts describe these elegant threads as gases swirling throughout the galaxy. Rounding up our exploration of the biggest discoveries made by the James Webb Telescope is WASP 96b, a hot, gaseous, and massive exoplanet spinning graciously at more than 10,000 light-years from our planet. This makes it the closest celestial object captured by the telescope. But critically, the picture quality is even better than some of the entries on our list. Data obtained from this image suggests a telltale signature of water vapor in this planet's atmosphere. Of course, this is one of the biggest indications that the planet could potentially support life, but the distance between the exoplanet and the star suggests otherwise. For perspective, WASP 96b is closer to its parent star than Mercury is to the Sun, which ultimately means that any life signature elements on the planet would most likely be disintegrated by heat.